Hi everyone, my name is Marian Tinda and I'm going to present our paper titled Mind the Gap, Aligning Software Engineering Education and Industry in Namibia. The paper is co-authored by Nico Apiola and Erki Sitonen. In Namibia, the software engineering discipline is evolving to be independent of the other computing disciplines, those disciplines being computer science, information technology, and information system. So graduates from those disciplines can be employed as software engineers and expect their degree to prepare them well for the industry and increase their employability. At the same time, the industry demands competent graduates, although this demand is not always met. So in November 2020, a researcher from the Finnish University of University of Turku's plug-in campus, the Future Tech Lab, in collaboration with Glodom Africa, used a focus group method to organize a webinar consisting of software engineers from diverse industry, a graduate programmer, and lecturers from three different universities in Namibia. The link to the webinar was shared on different online platforms, and it succeeded in attracting 49 local and international participants. So the webinar focused on discussing skills that novice software engineers should possess to thrive in the software engineering industry in Namibia. The webinar also aimed to bring together academics and industry practitioners to identify opportunities for industry-academia collaboration to narrow the industry-academia gap in Namibia. And lastly, the webinar introduced the plug-in campus of the University of Turku, which is a complementary category of overseas campus, which aims to collaborate with the host university instead of competing to grow highly competent software engineering graduates. So during this study, we looked at different studies, of which one was conducted in South Africa. So the authors interviewed software engineering managers, and although many skills were identified as those that software engineering graduates should possess, software development skills and business skills were emphasized as important skills, while business analysis and analytics, business processing modeling, mobile application development, and internationalization skills were identified as new skills. We also found that software industry's demand may be global. So for example, for graduates, good social and communication skills, and that different countries and their innovation ecosystem may have their unique situations and related challenges. So for example, a study in Norway shows that employers considered candidates' competencies to be adequate, while a similar study in South Africa found that that the ICT skills taught at university do not sufficiently prepare students for their roles in the industry. So in Namibia, no study of a similar nature was conducted. So in one particular case, students who attended university characterized by working and learning alternatively showed enhancement in employment opportunities. While in another study, it was found that industry partnered projects such as Capstone Project succeeded in introducing students to soft skills and assisted in preparing them for the industry. So to narrow the gap between industry and academia, hackathons, the offering of short courses and programming boot camps were identified, you know, as initiatives that the industry and the academia currently uses. And those initiatives are visible in Namibia. For example, the Namibia University of Science and Technology has been hosting hackathons on security and programming over the years since 2018. Other initiatives are also visible through the Future Tech Lab, UNAM and industry collaboration. So at the Future Tech Lab, a UNESCO Southern Summer School was held in collaboration with UNAM. The Future Tech Lab also in collaboration with UNAM, held a KIOS and a robotic workshop, among many other activities, including the collaboration between the Future Tech Lab and Cloudom Africa. Okay, so this study basically aimed at ascertaining the software industry expectations of software engineering graduate skills. It also aims at determining crucial gaps in industry academia collaborations in educating, preparing, and nurturing software engineering graduates with employable skills from lecturers and software engineers in Namibia. And lastly, the study also identified concrete future actions to address the industry academia gaps. So this study employed the focus group method, which has emerged as a fast and cost-effective technique used to collect qualitative data obtained from the experiences of practitioners and users. So, although different topics were discussed during this study, only two were presented in this paper. So the focus group basically consisted of three software engineering industry supervisors, both males, one graduate programmer, a female, and two male lecturer and one female lecturer, and they were both identified based on the similar characteristics, being of course computing graduates with a background in software engineering. Okay, so those are the questions that were asked, and I will not discuss them in detail due to time. So, as mentioned earlier, only two topics from the webinar are presented in this paper. So, the topics, of course, being the software engineering graduate skills is presented in the table, and also the role of industry academia collaboration from the industry perspective, and then from the academia perspective. Okay, so from the industry perspective, basically, the industry indicated that the graduates actually go through a test to assist them with the knowledge deficiency at the beginning of their internship, and then some professional also indicated that they give them projects to basically just test them and give them a chance to learn. And so the software engineering supervisor also advised that graduates start their internship at the beginning of their studies instead of joining the industry only at the end of their study. And then also the software engineering the professionals advised that Namibia should actually come up with a software engineering body of knowledge to help with the academia industry collaboration, and the body should consist of government, private, and universities and educational bodies. And then the software professionals also advise that the students should enroll in short courses to make up for the knowledge gap lost. And then from the academic side, to narrow the gap, the knowledge gap, universities actually try to send students for an internship, and they also try to integrate topics that allow students to master all level of software engineering. So at the same time, also they try to collaborate by bringing in innovative competition and hackathons, and then also boot camps, although not all students actually get a chance to participate in such a competition. So from this study, different technical skills and non-technical skills were identified that, of course, the software engineering graduates would possess, and they are all, you know, as displayed on the table, in the table. Okay, so it is important to encourage software engineering startups and also instigate offshore companies in Namibia. So such companies may invite a higher number of graduates for internships, exposing them to new professional and technological skills. So this will provide graduates and the industry with new opportunities, enabling graduates to thrive in a competitive software environment and seek employment both locally and internationally. So an enhanced industry-academia collaboration also supports improvement and innovation in the industry by ensuring industry relevant to academia. So when the university's curriculum is aligned to industry demands, graduates will contribute to society and there will be a significant economic impact. Also, this will contribute to the following sustainable development goals, SDG 4 and SDG 8. So SDG 4 advocates for inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. And SDG 4 directly contributes to SDG 8, which emphasizes decent work and economic growth to promote sustained, inclusive, and sustainable economic growth, full and productive employment, and decent work for all. In conclusion, this study actually found that there is a need for the software engineering ecosystem in Namibia to work together to narrow the industry academia gap. And then also, you know, by looking at bringing in more hackathons, offering short certificates and programming boot camps. The results also, the literature also showed that lack of faculty, raw and various fake project and resource limitation also contributes to the industry academia gap. And then also from the literature, it was the software development skills and business skills were some of the important skills that were identified, and those skills were also identified from our study. Okay, so since this study used a focus group method, results may not be generalized. So this basically calls for more future research with an extended methodology to back. So for future work, there is a need for the formulation of a software engineering body of knowledge to guide and create a platform for industry academia collaboration, and then also investigate the students' expectations of the industry, redesign a software engineering curriculum, and explore how software engineering instructors keep up with the industry. And then our work can actually be found on the website of the Future Tech Lab. So thank you for listening to my presentation, and I'm welcoming questions. Thank you.